That brings us to the most important property of sheet metal forming, that is formability. Formability is the ability of a sheet to undergo the desired shape change without failure, such as fracture. So it's basically what is the extent of complexity of shapes which can be made on a sheet metal without it undergoing fracture during forming. So that is the formability. And formability depends on certain factors, the first of which is the properties of the sheet metal. As we have seen, the elongation property, the anisotropic property, all those properties will come into play to form the metal. Second is the friction and lubrication of dies. So since the sheet panel is deformed by the die, it has to rub against the die and it has to be sufficiently lubricated so that it forms its shape. The third one is, of course, the types of dies, the die materials and the equipment used for forming. All those will factor in into the formability as well. Formability is a very important technological and economic factor which governs the product design feasibility. So if a component of a sheet metal is not formable, then it is not at all feasible to make that part for the product design. So this is a very important step for a product designer, that the formability of the part which he or she is designing has to be verified upfront during the product design stage itself. The formability of a specific sheet metal is generally determined using a formability test. So basically what is done is, a blank sheet of that material is taken and it is marked with the grid of circles. The grid of circles is generally 2.5 to 5 mm in diameter. As you can see over here, this is the sheet and it is marked with circles. Now what happens is, this blank sheet is then punched, or it's stretched over a punch until the grid pattern deforms and there is a tearing which is occurring on that pattern. So the blank is constrained and it is stretched over a punch. As seen over here, the punch deforms the sheet and it deforms the sheet until it tears. So naturally the circles will get deformed, and as you can see over here, the circles will become into ellipses. So these are deformed circles where the tear has occurred. If we measure the major axis and minor axis of these ellipses and compare it to the diameter of the circle, we will get the major strain and minor strain which has been obtained. Strain being the deformation which has occurred. So if this test is carried out for a series of samples, then the forming limit diagrams can be prepared, which can give an idea of the formability of the material.